To date, a case has not been documented in which the coronavirus has been transmitted to humans from surfaces contaminated with the virus. Still, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommends that frequently touched surfaces in your house should be routinely cleaned and disinfected to lessen the chances of transmission. But how exactly should you disinfect all the surfaces in your home? First off, be sure to read the labels of your products to ensure correct usage and safety. Use EPA-approved disinfectants, and it's best to use disposable gloves. If using reusable gloves, be sure to use them only while cleaning and disinfecting for the coronavirus. Always wash your hands immediately after taking the gloves off. Focus on cleaning and disinfecting the most frequently touched surfaces in your home. Think tables, doorknobs, handles, light switches, desks, toilets, faucets, sinks, and electronics. When it comes to electronics, research suggests that the virus can last a long time on these types of surfaces. For non-porous surfaces like a keyboard or a phone, research from the National Institutes of Health, CDC, Princeton University, and UCLA says that the virus could live on them for 2 to 3 days. The CDC suggests removing any visible contaminant if possible. To disinfect, you should follow the instructions from the manufacturer. Apple recently updated its guidelines for disinfecting its products. To clean your iPhone, you can clean it with a damp lens cloth, and then gently wipe it with a Clorox disinfecting wipe, while avoiding getting any moisture in any of the openings. You can also use the wipes on your other Apple products, such as your laptop. If your electronics manufacturer doesn't provide disinfecting instructions, the CDC suggests using alcohol wipes or sprays with at least 70% alcohol for touchscreens, and all surfaces should be thoroughly dried to avoid any pools of liquid forming. For hard surfaces, the coronavirus appears to last the longest on plastic and stainless steel, about 2 to 3 days. If your surfaces are dirty, be sure to first clean them with a detergent or soap and water before you disinfect. You can then use an EPA-approved disinfectant on the surface. Diluted household bleach solutions are an option, but make sure to follow the manufacturer's instructions for application. Make sure it's not expired, and never mix household bleach with ammonia or any other cleanser. Make sure to open a window so you get plenty of ventilation while and after applying the bleach. To make a bleach solution, mix 5 tablespoons of bleach per gallon of water or 4 teaspoons of bleach per quart of water. For soft surfaces, such as carpeted floor, rugs, and drapes, first, wipe off any dirt or contaminants you can see. Then, use an approved cleaner while following the cleaner's manufacturer instructions. If possible, put the items in the laundry according to their manufacturer instructions using the warmest appropriate water setting. Be sure to dry thoroughly. Dirty laundry from an ill person can be washed with other people's items, but if you need to handle laundry for someone who is sick, use disposable gloves or gloves that are dedicated to cleaning and disinfecting for the coronavirus. Do not shake dirty laundry. This will minimize the possibility of dispersing the virus through the air. Use the warmest water setting appropriate for your items and make sure they're dried thoroughly. Also, be sure to clean and disinfect your hamper. If possible, you should use liners that are disposable or washable. And finally, clean your hands immediately after using the gloves. If you don't use gloves, be sure to just wash your hands immediately after handling the laundry. Make sure you follow the CDC's additional home care guidelines on its website when caring for a sick person. If possible, allow a person to clean and disinfect their own bedroom and bathroom. And just a reminder, cleaning surfaces is not a substitute for washing hands. Experts say washing your hands with soap and water and avoiding touching your face are still the best ways to avoid contracting the virus. So, at the very least, keep washing those hands.